One of the things we go over, marching, skipping, jumping, all those things, all right? So really quickly, I want you guys to march, okay, all the way through half court. March looks like this. Bring your knees up as high as you can and bring your heel to the bottom of your glute here, or your hamstring, okay? So go ahead, march, all the way through half court. Arms just marching, just here. Take it slow. Be like everybody you want to go from 0 to 100, right? Take it slow. Be mindful. Go ahead. Next group. One after the other. One after the other. Go ahead. Quickly. Go ahead.
A tip. Because I used to coach kids that were 10 to 13 years old. And some of these concepts may be pretty hard to pick up. You know, how many of y'all have kids that when you guard them, they're all over them, right? Pass goes over here. This guy cuts over here. And they're so worried about their own player, right? That's not team defense, okay? So let me teach it how we teach it, and then try to hopefully apply some tips to how you can apply it to your team. So let's have the ball start right here, okay? Number one thing, on the ball, okay? We imprint this in our players' minds. No middle, no middle, no middle, no middle, no middle. Every team has their own different philosophy of how they want to funnel the ball into their defense. Some teams send it to the middle. Us, we believe in sending it to the baseline. We like the idea of if this person were to drive, say you drove me, okay? I want to use that baseline and that sideline as an extra defender. It just continues the time.
Point guard, good. Fill through, 10, come strong corner fill. 10, strong corner fill. Good. Swing it through the top, right here. You're high and wide. Up top, stagger away. Stagger, straight. Come on up. 24, flatten out. That initiates you to come to the elbow. Great, either elbow you want. Now we're going splits. Go play with him. You curl. You pop back. Yes, get him. Very good, guys. Can we do it one more time?
To do. The year that I sat out, Coach K, we were working on our dummy offense, and I'm not playing, so I'm just running the offense, and he stops, and he says, what are you doing? And I said, running the offense. He said, but you were open. He said, I'm not playing, so I'm getting the guys who are gonna play the ball. He said, no, that's not how we do things. He's like, I need you to be the guy you're gonna be next year, so you don't have to fight for it next year. He said, if you pass the ball again, you might as well transfer again. And when he said that to me, it gave me a lot of confidence. And if you watch me play, you understand. All right, so transferring into that, it was like my senior year, I didn't even start the first 7 games. We got a class in with Shane Battier and Elton Brand, Will Avery. We had a really good class. Preseason, top three, ended up. I knew he was a good coach. He put me in the first 2 minutes. I had 8 points and 4 rebounds. I was like, I'm getting 50. And he took me out. And he didn't put me back in until the last minute and a half with the walk-ons. And I was pissed. Man, this dude don't know what he's talking about. He can't do that. See, I'm going to come back next year, man. I don't need these 10 games. I'm from Jersey City, man. Tell me what you want. He wouldn't tell me. So I'm flying back to Jersey with Elton Brand. We're going into New York. And Elton Brand, I'm pissed. I'm like, I can't believe Coach doing this to me. Elton says, well, Ro, if you play a little bit harder, you'd be the best player on the team. It's a freshman. And I looked at him like I'm getting ready to punch him in the face, but he was probably right. So when I got home, playing for Bob Hurley, after November and 24th, that's when basketball season starts in New Jersey, so it's a little bit late. Went home, I did 2-a-days with my high school. They had Anthony Perry, they had, you know, 9 Division I players, so it was really a college practice. And I had to remember who I was. And that role that Coach K said to me when I first transferred. So when I came back, I was a better player than when I left. And Elton Brand broke his foot, and Coach K said, oh my God, I don't know what we're gonna do. Our best player is gone. And I stood up and I said, Coach, I'm the best player.
And the thing I would say, you know, especially seeing Don, Tony, and Deion up here, is coaches learning from their players. I think, especially as you get to a higher level and you're working with better and better players, I would just, you know, I think there's a ton that you give to them, but I would encourage you to be open to listening and learning and observing them. And it's amazing what I've learned watching, you know, our Hawks players. It's amazing what I've learned watching our Hawks assistant coaches. I know these guys were out here earlier tonight with drills and different things that we do. And I'll just tell you, it's impressive for me tonight to see this many people. And I know there were a lot more here earlier, that you're still open to learning. You're still open to growing. And everybody up here, I think, feels the same way as I do. I'm constantly